Hello everyone, in this video you have one triangle and here is 15, here is 30, and then these two parts are equal and alpha is x. Okay, we'll calculate value of alpha using three different ways. Let's start with first method. If we create an equilateral triangle, so let's take here 15 degrees, and then if we connect these two corners, these angles must be 60 degrees, right? Because of equilateral triangle. And then let's call here K and here T. Notice that the line TC is a bisector line, right? Okay. And then here, this angle must be 90 degrees. And we know that these two parts must be equal because of perpendicular. So let's write here, QCB triangle is an equilateral triangle. That means KC, KB, and BC, these are equal sides, right? Okay, and then if we connect K and D point like this. Notice that here is 90 degrees and these two parts are equal. That means this triangle is an isosceles triangle. Right? So BDK triangle is an isosceles triangle. That means KD must be equal DB. Okay. And then if we connect point K and point A like this, let's remind you, if these three parts are equal, that means vertex must be equal 90 degrees, right? So angle AKB equal 90 degrees. And then for this triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. That means 15 degrees left here. Okay. Notice that AKC triangle is also isosceles triangle. So AK must be equal KC, right? So these two sides are equal. And then we know that KCB triangle is an equilateral triangle, so these two sides must be equals to others. And then notice that we get an isosceles right triangle. Therefore, AKB triangle is an isosceles right triangle. So AK must be equal KB, right? And then angle KAB equals 45 degrees. That means alpha equal 30 degrees. Second method, let's draw perpendicular line and let's extend this corner, and then let's draw one more perpendicular and let's call here theta. That means here must be equal theta, and then let's call here beta. So here must be equal beta. Okay. I'm going to call here E, and notice that this triangle and this triangle are congruent, right? Because opposite of the 90 degrees have same length. Okay. Let's call here F. So AED triangle and BFD the triangle are congruent, right? Therefore, if there's a one unit opposite of the theta, opposite of the theta must be equal one unit. And then, if there is an x unit opposite of the beta, opposite of the beta must be equal x unit. Right? Okay. Notice that if there's a y unit opposite of the 30 degrees, opposite of the 60 degrees must be equal root 30. And then notice that if there's a y unit opposite of the 15, opposite of the 75 degrees here must be equal root 3 plus 2 units. That means 2x plus root 3 equal root 3 plus 2. Is again, that means x equal 1 unit. So if here is 1, that means we get an isosceles triangle. So theta must be equal beta equal 45 degrees. And then for this triangle, we know that 2 interior angles equals 1 exterior angles. That means alpha equal 30 degrees. Now let's calculate the value of alpha using third method. Okay. First step, let's call these equal sides x, and here let's call y. And we know that 2 interior angles equals 1 exterior angles. And then for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, angle DBC equal 135 minus alpha, right? Okay. Let's apply sine rule, y over sine 135 minus alpha equal x over sine 30. And that means x over y equal sine 30 over sine 135 minus alpha. Okay, this is the first equation. And then let's apply sine rule for this triangle. Let's apply sine rule for triangle ADC, y over sine alpha equal x over sine 15. That means x over y equal sine 15 over sine alpha, right? This is the second equation. If we equalize first and second equation, therefore sine 30 over sine 135 minus alpha equal sine 15 over sine alpha, right? And then we know that the expansion of sine 30 equal 2 times sine 15 times cosine 15, or we can calculate sine 45 minus alpha instead of sine 135 minus alpha, right? Equals sine 15 over sine alpha. And then let's simplify the expression. These are again Let's move to the 2 here. And we can calculate sine 75 instead of cosine 15, right? Over sine 45 plus alpha equal, we know that we can write sine 30 instead of 1 over 2 over sine alpha. That means alpha equal 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.